All right. Hotep, spiritual family. So I am just going to be doing like a quick video, okay? I want to give some tips on blocking yourself spiritually. And also, you know, I guess this is a video two in one, the power of the word. And as I go further along, I want to do a complete video on the word, the power, because this is what I've been getting, like a download. But in the meantime, what I want to impress upon folks, when you say you are a spiritualist, this is a title that you hold. This is not, you know, and this is not we're better than anybody else, no. But you have to realize when you become spiritually awakened, you are not a regular degular anymore, okay? You have now become part of a spiritual, awakened, conscious individual. You've become part of, you know, the collective consciousness, because what's going to happen is when this collective consciousness fully awakens, we will take our power back from the so-called establishments, because there has been so much that has been done to us, and we have been so indoctrinated and programmed, okay? We don't even realize that we're programmed when we get up in the mornings just rushing to get to work, you know, or to get to school, and we don't even take a moment to just do a couple of deep breaths and to center ourselves and to unblock ourselves. When the ancients, you know, like Lao Tzu or Sun Tzu or those, you know, Taoists, Buddhists, and others, the ancient Kemites, you know, Ptah, you know, Seshat, Aset, and they talked about, you know, about, they talked about being stable in spirit. They talked about being at peace, being at one with nature, with self, higher self, you know, the cosmos. They practiced what they teach. A lot of spiritualists, you know, contact me, and, you know, very people that are on their spiritual paths, and they feel blocked, okay? They feel like nothing is moving for them. And the reason that is because folks don't do the work that they need to do to clear themselves on a regular, okay? First of all, when I come in from outdoors, every single day I burn an incense in my house. Every single day. In my bedroom, downstairs in my living room, I do incense every single day. And that's because, you know, we're electromagnetic beings. We come in and we have energies that we have picked up. And you want to make sure that you are clearing yourself, you know. Just a second. Okay, I'm back. And so when we talk about clearing ourselves, we're talking about using things like, I got a big ass bag, you know. This is Palo Santo, you know, and I will use the Palo Santo to clear. Just another second. I've gotten my lighter before then, but you know, you want to use, you know, stuff to clear your body on a regular. If you are not cleansing every day with some form of sage, Palo Santo, you really have buildup of negative energy, okay? And I'm just gonna stand up and I'm gonna show the collective, you know, what I do. You know, you gotta be careful not to burn yourself with this also when I show you what I'm getting ready to do. I'm just gonna let it, you know, and it gets a nice smoke buildup. So what I will do, I will put it underneath my shirt. And the smoke will come all up through my chest. See it coming all up through my chest? It's coming all up through my chest area. And what I will do is I will do my back area. This is for my root chakra. You understand? And so this is how, you know, I cleanse myself. I do my third eye. I go up to my, you know, my crown and I cleanse. I go in the back to my, you know, my pineal gland. I cleanse my hands because, you know, your hands are what you make money with. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't think to cleanse their hands, but you better cleanse them hands if you want to, you know, have that money coming in. And you do the bottom of your feet, you know. And what I will do is I will light this and I will even go over my bed, okay? Like when I go to sleep and things like that and I wake up the next day, before I go back in bed that night, I do a Palo Santo and I go over my pillow. I go over my bed sheets. You have got to be cleansing on a regular. You want to do your throat chakra. And my crazy Jamaican ass, I'll even put this in my mouth. Don't burn yourself. And this is cleansing the throat chakra. Okay, now you don't have to do that. But you want to get the throat chakra. You want to get all over your body. And this really spiritual family is cleansing 101. The same thing with sage. Okay? The same thing with sage. You go all, and I keep sage. I have saged all over. You know what I'm saying? I have a bag of Palo Santo. And this is just one bag. I got a couple more bags. And I got a couple of bags of sage because I keep these because I do readings from Tuesdays to Fridays. And, you know, I'll do three readings a day where I do the goddess number 3, 6, and 9. 3 is a maiden, 6 is the mother, and 9 is the crone. And so, you know, when I do those readings, you know, I cleanse myself first. And then I will cleanse myself after. And once a week, I make sure to take a spiritual bath. Because as I'm reading for people, I am tuning into their energy. I'm tuning into their frequency. We're electromagnetic beings. Even if we're just over the phone speaking, I'm picking up and reading their energy. And if they come in with anything, there's anything around them. That's energy that I keep at bay. Also, show the folks at home. I wear a lot of crystals. This is, you know, black tourmaline. This is obsidian, onyx, black tourmaline, labradorite, numite, and this is shungite. Shungite is especially good, you know, for these 5G energy, okay? These 5G energy fields. And so you want to make sure that you are protected. You know what I'm saying? And so, you know, and I have my Solomon keys here in the front that I work with, you know, my five-pointed star, and I got, you know, my Erzuli Dantor piece, my Tiamat, you know, and of course my Ankh. And I have, you know, a couple of pieces on my feet. So I make sure that I stay spiritually strapped out in these streets. You understand? Because here's the thing. Enemies come with the territory. Because you may have a YouTube channel and random people will come and see your content. And, you know, haters come with the territory. That's just what it is. You can't get away from that. But you can protect yourself from these hating assholes that will come across and see your content and will want to throw at you. Because right now I have a priest in my circle who's a very powerful Ogun priest and somebody is throwing at him, you know, in his family. Now he works with Ogun. What are the odds that he is driving and there's some police in an unmarked car that pull up and gave him a $250 ticket, you know, saying that he didn't stop enough time in a stop sign. He ran a stop sign. And of course, he's going to handle that. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and dispute that and handle that. So, you know, I mean, but why would that happen? And not that we live in a time when certain things can't happen, because things happen all the time. But that particular incident, that was not just a natural incident, just this random. That is somebody throwing, because he makes his money through doing like DoorDash and, you know, things like that. So why would he be getting a ticket where they want to take like 4 points off his license? No, we're not going for that. You know what I'm saying? We're going to get rid of that. So, you know, and I know when I do my videos and I tell people that the sacrifice of animals are not necessary, you know, they don't need to be going and getting initiated. You know I get, you know, some stuff thrown at me. But I don't worry about that because I let it be known. I don't care what somebody else want to do. But understand, I am that witch that I will defend me and mine. And I don't take no pleasure into going into spiritual warfare. And the reason I don't is because when I go into spiritual warfare, I pretty much go in to kill a person. I don't do slaps on the wrist. You know what I'm saying? If I come for that ass, you know what I'm saying? You're pretty much going to die. So, and that's just how it is, because, you know, that's just what it is, because, you know, we aren't one of the ones that was disarmed, you know, because in religion, and we'll just go back again, you know, under the age of Pisces, which Pisces is ruled over by Jupiter, and Jupiter is the planet of expansion. If everything is at a 1, Jupiter will make it a 20. So it makes sense that religion went all over the planet and colonized, and we're still indoctrinated. When you look at, you know, like the our ancestors that were enslaved, and they made, you know, the slave masters rich, which the money was passed down through their generation, you know, family dynasties that own things like McDonald's and things like that, that are $1 billion corporation that's still paying $15 an hour. Houseway, you know what I'm saying? When you can't even afford an apartment in Georgia at $15 an hour. But these are $1 billion corporations that they make billions of dollars, and you are still getting paid minimum wage. This is how the rich stay richer and the poor stay poorer. Meanwhile, you know, you're working like a dog from the time you hit, you know, you get to work at McDonald's, you hit the ground running, you know, you're just busy all day, just running, 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 running. And we are indoctrinated to think that, you know, you have to be a work slave. You have to be doing all of this. You understand? For you to feel fulfilled. And when you look at the ancients, Kemetic, the ancient, you know, philosophers, Lao Tzu, Sun Tzu, and all of those, you know, they lived pretty simple lives. You don't have to be out here killing yourself, because actually the time that we are in and where we're further going, a lot of the jobs are going to be done from home. People are going to be working for themselves. This whole dynamic is going to change, because this really that is set up is still slavery. It is modern day slavery. It never ended. It just really got, you know, it just got a different face put on it. You understand? Because when you are working for a $1 billion corporation and you are only getting $15 an hour, that is not a lot of money. And in the state that you're living in, you still can't afford. Look at the homeless rate. And this is why, you know, I want to show folks some stuff. In 2022, the preliminary data shows that nearly 50,000 Americans died by suicide. Let me hold that up. 50,000 Americans died by suicide. Okay? Marking it the highest number of Americans lost on record. The country saw a 2.6 increase in the number of suicide deaths from 2021. You understand? This is 50,000 people taking their lives. Why? Not only that, but on a spiritual level, as in life, so in death. When these people take their lives, they just don't miraculously travel on to the great beyond and they're okay. No, their spirits are trapped here. This is why the energy on the planet is the way it is. Look at the misery on the planet. The poverty, the homelessness, the violence, the sickness, the despair, the rage, the panic, the fear. This is why the frequency is the way it is and why even those of us, myself included, that are very sensitive to these energies feel it on such a deep level that if I didn't work constantly and to shield myself and to do my mantras, to clear myself, to do my prayers, you know, to do, and when I say prayer, using the power of the word to rebuke and revoke and nullify these energy, if I wasn't who I was, I would have offed myself a long time ago. Because just feeling these energies, and you know, it's like when you are very psychically sensitive, when you are not psychically sensitive, when you have the ability to tap in, and I've often said it's like having your finger on the pulse of humanity, the collective, okay? You feel the energy. This is why when I do ritualistic work, I do for the collective. Nubian ancestors. Just one second. I should have got all this stuff before I did this, but I didn't know like I was gonna, you know, go into some of these things. But I want, you know what? I don't even have to pause that. What I want folks to know, the Dogon tribes in Africa, you know, have given you the tools. Now we know we have the tools that we can use. Okay, before we didn't have these tools because we were under Christianity. Now that we're in the age of Aquarius, which is the age of the return of Saturn, let's never forget that the age of Aquarius is ruled. The ancient ruler is Saturn. I use the ancient calendars. I don't deal with this Uranus, Pluto, because Uranus to me is baby Saturn. Pluto is Mars. The ancient ruler of Scorpio is Mars. You know what I'm saying? Neptune is the moon. But whatever. You know what I'm saying? You can still use those, but understand that you have to be tapping into the ancient energies because this is what, you know, these are the correct paths. And so, with we got the Kemetic calendar. Okay, I got a few stuff here, but let me see. The Kemetic calendar. And so when we go to the Kemetic calendar, August 21st is going to be the ancestral holy day. That is August 21st. And then we go to August 31st, which is another ancestral holy day. Okay? What I want folks to understand, now that you have access to this comedic calendar, and you can go to the Earth Center and you can buy the full calendar, because I have the paper calendar and I have the one on my phone. You can go and look at when these days, you know, are at its apex. Now, when the ancestral holy day is at its apex, this is when you do ancestral work. Like when it was the Lion's Gate, the 8-8, I was doing ancestral work for the collective ancestors, that the ones who died in the Atlantic slave trade, the Middle Passage, that their spirits, you know what I'm saying? That their spirits be elevated. That, you know, even the ones before us on the continent in Africa that sold us into slavery, because there's still slavery going on the continent. We are the ones who sold our own into slavery. You understand? Don't just get it twisted that folks just ran up on the continent and was just snatching folks. No, folks was going around, you know, fighting with other tribes and snatching people up and selling them. And so as a collective, we have a lot of work to do for forgiveness for the ancestors. Because I'm telling you, there's some of those ancestors that are still angry. You know what I'm saying? And so when I do the work, and I do the work for the collective ancestors, I did this on the 1st of August. And I did it on the 8th of August. So on the 1st of August, let me see. I think on the 1st of August, it was an ancestral holy day. Let me see here. The 1st of August. Yep. The 1st of August was an ancestral holy day. And the Lion's Gate was open. So I was doing work for the collective Nubian ancestors, that their spirits will be elevated, that any transgressions that was committed be remitted, and that they be able to move on peacefully. Because let me tell you something, until we start to do work, like collectively, everybody on this planet, because everyone that is here now, we all came here to be part of this collective awakening and spiritual elevation and consciousness, and we all have a part to play. And so we not only do work to elevate ourselves, but we also should be doing work to elevate the collective consciousness. Okay? And we do that, you know, when we do our, you know, when you light a candle or you light an incense or you pour libations, one of the things is you want to speak into the water. And, you know, when it talks about, you know, the power of the word, life and death is in the power of the tongue. You understand? And we have got to be using the word. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with goddess, and the word was goddess. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Now imagine that the word is like a light on your path. That means when you speak these words and you speak them into the ancestral realm, if there's any darkness, the word, the power of the word. This is why the ancient Egyptians was very adamant about elevating your sacred Heka, because then your word becomes a light. You understand? Heaven and earth will pass away, but the words of the Great Mother will not pass away. Gracious words are like a honeycomb, sweetness to the soul and health to the body. That means the power of the word can heal. death, life and death are in the power of the tongue. In the beginning, the Word was the Word, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. You don't, I mean, look at all those verses that talks about the power of the sacred Heka. And this is one of the reasons why we are feared, because when we fully are activated spiritually, we will become, you know, like the X-Men. You understand? Because the words will be like, look at the vast oceans. The oceans, they don't rush, but they accomplish the task of shaping continents. Rivers carves valley. You understand? And this is a little note. Elevate your ancestors from fear. As in life, so in death. Use the Dogon ancestral holy days when the ancestral energy is at its highest. You now have the ritual, the days, the words of power that will impart to your ancestors to elevate them through the power of the word. The ancient spirits of the Nomos, use those words to rebuke fears. And let me just go back into a little of what I have talked about. Like, and this is what was shown to me, because I get these downloads. Like, if you have your ancestor, as in life, so in death, and they're still trapped in the energy of back in the day of slavery, and you got one that's running from an overseer on a horse with a whip. If you haven't done the ritual to elevate them, they're still having that experience on the other side. But when you do the ritual, you know what I'm saying? To elevate them, they're either going to stop and say, I'm not running anymore. Grab the whip and snatch that whip. And then that apparition of that overseer will disappear. And when that disappears, they have now been elevated to another level. Now they can walk peacefully along. They can help elevate others. You understand? But you still got to keep doing the work, because it takes some time to elevate them till they transition off of that. What we have in the world is that every person who dies a violent death, you know, was murdered, civil war, whatever, these energies are still trapped here. This is why, you know, you have so many people that commit suicide, because it's not just from what's going on in their lives. It's what they feel. People feel energy. They feel pain. They feel abandonment. They feel fear on a level that they can't even verbalize. And for some people, it becomes too much to bear, and they end up taking their lives. And, you know, as a metaphysical counselor, I've worked with people that have that kind of fear. And I have to let them know that this is not your feeling that you're feeling. Because I know when I feel like that, and I feel these intense feeling like, oh, snap, I want to off myself. This is not me. I don't live a life that is horrible to where I want to be, you know, I want to be removed from that life. This is not me. This is what I am picking up in the ether. Remember the saying, we wrestle not against flesh, but against spirits and principality. There are spirits, energy. Remember, everything is energy. Energy never dies. It has to go somewhere. So if these energies are still here, people can feel them. And this is why, until collectively, you know, people are going around the earth and saging, you know, saging outside, you know what I'm saying? Making some water with some Florida water, some rosemary essential oil or whatever, speaking into it and throwing it up, that be released, go on. We have got to get to a point. We're not there yet. Like, you know, in the 60s when, you know, the age of Aquarius just came in and everybody, the age of Aquarius, you know, and people was going around with incense and all of this stuff, you know, and in that feel good energy. We're not doing that. The 80s came in with the greed. The age of consumerism is going to die out. There's a lot of malls that are closing down because we are going to shift from that energy. We are going to shift from the greed energy because we are still indoctrinated. We are still programmed. And the establishment that rules for now, their power is finished. They're hanging on with Kung Fu Death Grip because their time here is done. And that doesn't mean that they're just going to let go and peacefully ride off into the sunset. No, they're going to do everything to hang on to that power. But it's done. It's just like the Greek Empire, the Roman Empire, the Kemetic Empire, the Babylonians, the Sumerians, the Chaldeans. Empires rise and fall. That's just the natural order of life. And in the age of Aquarius, whose ancient ruler is Saturn, after the age of Aquarius, it's going to be the age of Capricorn. And that ruler of Capricorn is also Saturn. Mother is going to, it's about 4,000 years cleaning up this bitch. Like the other day, I was watching a video on YouTube, and it was some European country, I think Dutch, whatever they're called, Dutch, I think the Dutch, or one of those European countries, and they were apologizing for their ancestors' role in slavery. Okay, well, we really don't care about your apology. Cut the check, bitches. Reparations, because let's not get it twisted. Our ancestors worked to make your ancestors wealthy. And a lot of y'all still have that money. You know what I'm saying? That have been passed down through generations after generation, generational wealth. All we asking for, you know what I'm saying? Reparations, which is fair. That's even in the Bible. You know what I'm saying? If you have a man as a slave and he works for you for 7 years, after you know that 7 years is up, you know, you repay him, you give him oxens and whatever. Cut the check, bitches. That's all we're saying. We don't care about your apologies. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it is. It's what's fair and balanced, and it's what all of these things have got to even itself out in this age of Aquarius. Because the ancient ruler of Aquarius is Saturn. Okay? And Saturn is all about justice. You understand? Saturn is... Oh, shit. Look, we're... Today is Tuesday. Today is Mars Day, Ogun's Day. And guess what? We're in a Saturn hour. Discipline, patience, obstacle, repair. Training, hard and long works, responsibility, ancestors, age, maturity, hierarchy, foundation, structure, administration, organization, command, stability, slavery. Saturn did rule over slavery because there was some shit that went down with our people that, you know, it was foretold that the infants would rule over us for a certain time. You know what I'm saying? Command, caution, honor, duty, law, restriction, deprivation, reality, pragmatism, prudent, punctuality, obligation, and principle. Everything that has ever happened, that is happening, is karma. It doesn't matter. Even, you know, everybody has a part to play. Even the people that comes here as mercenaries, as killers. It is some type of karmic energy. And then there are other things where there are entities on this planet that can, you know, take a hold of people and have people doing some crazy stuff like serial killers. These are entities. Okay, some of these people have some of these, because not every entity is bad. Everything has its polarity, but you have some entity that are just here. You have beings that are here that is just to cause chaos and, you know, to cause the most horrific things. And this is why you have to stay spiritually protected. And so another thing is looking at, here we go, tuning forks, okay? Tuning forks are very, very important. You got the 120 hertz tuning fork that helps with your nervous system. You know what I'm saying? 256 hertz, you know, that helps to let go of fear, worry, and stress and anxiety. For people who suffer from high anxiety, fear, worry, need to, you know, pick up a tuning fork of 256 hertz. And what I do, I use a, this is a selenite wand. I'll put the description down in the bottom where you can go on eBay and get it. And I'll even, you know, put the tuning fork information. They're on Amazon where you can get these tuning forks. And so when you look at the, and let me just go here, selenite properties. Selenite helps to remove blocks. You know what I'm saying? Selenite is, is a stone. It's calming and it's excellent for meditation and spiritual work. It assists in judgments and insight. It clears confusion and aids in seeing the deeper picture. Selenite aligns the spiritual columns and promotes a more clearer insight in seeing things. It is good for deep peace and calming. And I sleep with selenite. I sleep with selenite in my bed. I usually have one in one hand and I have one in another hand. So when I go to sleep, I have two wands of selenite. And what I do with my tuning fork, okay, and this is my tuning fork of 256. What I do is I put the selenite over my head and I go over. I put the selenite on my head and I go over my crown chakra. I put it over my heart and I go all over my heart and I can feel the relaxation. You know what I'm saying? I put it in my chest. You can put it in your sacral chakra. You can go all over your pineal gland. You go all over your body. And I have all the different tuning forks. There are about 8 or 9 of them for different parts of the body. There's one, you know, for the your crown, your third eye, your throat chakra, you know, your sacral chakra, your root chakra, all of your chakras. All the chakras have a tuning fork. But I, you know, when there are others, but I will use this one. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, you just go over your body with this, with your tuning forks. And these are some of my other tuning forks that I use. You understand? And sometimes I'll even get a couple of them, different ones. This is 285 hertz and this is 396 hertz. Thank you. You understand? I'll just knock them together and I'll just go all down my body, all over my head, all over the side of my ears to, you know, because it's working on your electromagnetic field. You understand? And this is the way that you keep yourself clear. Get a couple of tuning forks and sleep with them in your bed before you go to bed at night. Clear your auric field. You know, your electromagnetic field. You understand? Because here is the thing. We are surrounded by a bubble of light and energy can attach itself. Sometimes your auric field can become pierced to where energy starts leaking out. This is where you start feeling tired and lethargic and people start feeling blocked because they have all types of energy attached to their auric field. People don't clean themselves. Look, the bottom of your feet. You know what I'm saying? You got to go on the bottom of your feet. Of course, you take off your sneakers, you know. You understand? You got to do, you know, do your root chakra. You got to go all over. You understand? Because we are electromagnetic beings. That's surrounded by, you know, a bubble and different, you know, frequencies. And you want to clear. In this day and age, in the age of Aquarius, folks got to realize you can't just, okay, you're a spiritually awakened being. And I've done a video on this about having a routine. You have to have a routine. The monks, the Shaolin monks, they get up. They meditate every single day. They do a mantra. And what is so wonderful about this day and age that we are living in? You can go on YouTube. You know what I'm saying? And you can get a mantra. You know, I know one of the mantras that I listen to, it's the Om mantra. Let's see. The Om mantra. Okay, yeah, this is one of the ones. And this is the Om chanting that removes all negative blocks. You feel me? Om. Yeah, and so I will use one that is for 8 hours. And then I will have another window open up where I have an 8 hour, 960 hertz house cleaning. That removes old negative trapped energy in your home. You understand? This is, these are these Sofegalo frequencies. This one is 8 hours, 963 hertz house cleansing that removes old negative energy from your home. Now you have that with another window open with the 8 hour Om chanting. You know what I'm saying? 8 hours of chanting the Om, which is the 528 hertz. You understand? And you light an incense before you go to bed. You have now cleansed your entire environment in your home. And listen, we live in a time somebody can buy themselves a cheap ass Chromebook. You understand? And you always have it plugged up. You know what I'm saying? You always have it to where it is charged up. And I will leave like two or three windows open when I leave, and it's playing all throughout the house I'm renting. You feel me? And you know, soon as I come in the house, I light up some incense. And now I've cleansed my entire home. I've cleansed, you know, my entire area. Before I go to bed at night, you know what I'm saying? I'm doing my tuning fork. I'm going all over. And I am, you know, cleansing any energies. And so this is what, you know, is used. Because we are in the age now where there is all kinds of information. You are getting the ritual. This Palo Santo stick is a ritual that you will use to cleanse yourself. You know what I'm saying? And you have your tuning fork. You have, you know, you have your selenite wands. Now you have gotten a ritual that you can incorporate, that you keep yourself clear and balanced. Right now, we should all be wearing, you know, some form of shungite to help to protect us from the 5G towers. Just all the things that they're throwing out in the environment. And so this is how you keep yourself protected. This is how you keep yourself balanced and aligned. And this is how, you know, spiritually you don't have any blocks, so that when you do go to do your spiritual work will be successful. You're always in a place spiritually of where, you know, you're a spiritual kung fu master. You feel me? So on that note, I hope everybody enjoyed this video. Until next time, same bat channel, same bat time. All right. All right.